probably is just filthy.
All right, really fast.
Fecal matter in it.
We'll get you a ball. Relax. Let's say hi to Stalker Patty. We got to get an update here. Stalker Patty.
Hey, how are you?
Good. What's going on today?
Oh, nothing much. Nothing much has happened so far. I just woke up.
All right.
Oh, sweet dreams. Did you have sweet dreams last night?
Yeah, I did.
Dreaming of not being a virgin anymore?
Oh, no, just... I don't know. I don't remember what I dreamed.
I woke up. My bed was wet. I think I'm a squirter.
My cat. Oh. Actually, I just sleep with my cat. I have a pet that gets right into the bed with me.
Poor cat.
I know.
Imagine you're looking out and it's like, ah, oh, anyone could have adopted me. I could have been in a nice house, but here I am living with Patty.
Patty's twat is like catnip for the cat because it hasn't been washed out in 20 years.
Patty, do you... Do you rub a little cat food down there and let him lick away with that sandpaper tongue?
No, I'm not that desperate.
What do you mean you're not that desperate?
I'm not that desperate.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are. You're as desperate as they come. You haven't had sex ever.
Ever, and you're 50 years old.
Well, don't worry.
I'm not worried.
Trust me, I'm not worried. I don't lose sleep over the fact that you're still a virgin.
Well, first of all, I got to find a boyfriend, and then I can get busy.
All right. Well, where are we?
Get busy. Yeah, slow down on the lingo. I'm going to get busy. You won't be getting busy till you're having sex for 20 years. You'll lay there and take it.
I'll make up for lost time.
All right. Well, where are we with finding a gynecologist to check out Starker Patty's twat? No one has come to the table. It's amazing.
We get emails about everything under the sun, and people want to help us. Not one. What's wrong, Jim?
Jimmy's horrified.
What are you doing? You just took
a
side.
We asked for a ball, and he got a
knife. I didn't take anything.
Now we all have to look at you.
No, you don't.
What did you do?
I didn't take anything. Go back to what you were doing.
What happened?
Nothing.
That's a nice bowl.
Are you mad at the bowl now?
No. I want to eat something, a bowl out of shit that people have been eating out of for 6 months. That's what you want to eat your breakfast out of.
Someone just brought in a bowl, and it's, I don't know. Are there any facilities to wash things around here?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. I won't. It's not important. Just come back.
Oh, poor Jimmy.
I'm not eating out of a bowl that somebody else has used. I'm not doing it. Go ahead.
But you can just...
Not happening.
No, I wouldn't either. I understand.
You can just wash the bowl out.
It's very nice that he went and brought in a bowl, but
fantastic. He's a great
truth
guy.
Of the matter is, you can't eat out of a bowl you don't know
the
where
guy
it's
was
been.
Happy. He came in all excited like he solved your bowl problem,
but
and
you don't
like that
been.
Bowl.
Absolutely you don't know where it's not. Been.
Does it look dirty?
Doesn't matter. I'd rather eat it out of Patty's box. I'm not eating cereal out of a bowl that somebody that Frank Sinatra guy was probably losing his hair in 2 weeks ago.
Jimmy's in a bad mood today. I love it. I do like when you're in a
sleep, man. I'm really.
I love when Norton's in a bad mood. This is gonna be an awful show. Hold on tight, kids. All right, Patty. So I don't even know what we were talking about because we had a look at Norton's bowl. Oh yeah, the gynecologist, Ben. We still can't find a gynecologist. This lady hasn't had her vag checked out in 20 years.
Who would want to look at that?
Well, dude, gynecologists, it's, you know, they take an oath.
Yeah, this
sworn oath that they must care for these people.
Yeah, the oath is they can't turn down a vagina.
No.
They get the really hot 17-year-old girl coming in for her first visit, and then they get the 85-year-old lady that wants to make sure, you know, it's still happening.
That's the same oath Jimmy took. You can't turn down a vagina no matter what it's stuck on. 70-year-old women.
All right, Patty, what's going on with Lady Di?
Nothing. I haven't gotten anything yet. I'm still waiting.
Oh, yeah. She hasn't sent over her resume?
Yeah, if you guys haven't followed this little soap opera. Shut up, Patty.
Yes?
Shut up. Be a good listener. We need listeners on this show. I was trying to set you up.
Okay.
Stalker Patty's trying to find Lady Di a job, is all I wanted to say.
Yeah, she's been out of work for quite a while. She's a drunk, and she gets fired from her jobs. And now Patty's trying to step up and help her out. She said, give her her resume, and she'll...
And you still haven't gotten the resume from Lady Di?
Not at all.
Huh. Lady Di.
How you doing? Patty, I sent you the resume.
I haven't gotten it yet.
Well, I don't know. I sent it to you the other day.
What a liar.
Where?
You are a liar.
Well, you know, if you sent it the other day, it takes a couple days. I'll give you till Friday for that resume.
Okay.
If you sent it the other day, I know how the mail works.
Right, yeah.
I used to say the same thing about bills.
Oh, I sent that check.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I did. I'm sounding all sincere. No, really, I sent the check. I think Patty would be an ass as a boss. You could just hear it in her voice. If she had a little power...
She does have a little power. It could give.
So, Lady Di, where did you send the resume?
No, I did send the resume. I did.
Where? Where did you send it?
I put it in the mail.
To where?
From where I live. I put it right in the mail.
Where did you?
The mailman took it and, you
what,
know.
Who was it addressed to?
Why are we dealing with retards this early in the morning?
It was addressed to Patty.
And where does Patty live? Like, just give
Well, I'm not gonna say where she lives, but she lives in New York, New York. That's okay.
And where did you mail? When did you mail it?
I mailed it about maybe 2-3 days ago. Right now.
Well, she should have gotten it.
Well, you know, she will get it. She'll get the resume.
You're lying. You didn't mail it 2 or 3 days ago.
She's such a liar.
I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. You know, I did. So, what can I tell you?
Yeah. Okay. Great. And you're looking forward to maybe getting a job?
Yes, I am.
And waking up and going to work on a daily basis instead of hanging out at night getting drunk?
No, I don't do that.
You absolutely do. We called you the other day, and you were drinking with two guys in your apartment or house or wherever you live.
Stop it.
She tries to defuse it by laughing, but you just know it's just a mess.
I thought you had a job as the Sheik's lawyer.
No.
All right, well, there's nothing here, right?
What?
No.
This thing isn't developing at all. All right, so, Starker Patty, why don't you call us when you get to, Lady Di's resume, all right?
Oh, I will. She'll get it pretty soon.
All right.
She'll get the resume.
Let me make a prediction. She will not get that.
No. The office will be finished before she gets that resume.
You know
fat, lazy slug.
What? You know what she told me that really bothers me? She says that if she has a job, she'll lose her public assistance.
Oh, you're one of those people.
Oh,
you'd rather stay on the welfare.
And that might be a hesitancy that you get so dependent on something, you know?
Yeah, that's right, Patty.
I'm not saying anything.
Oh, she doesn't want to lose her public assistance. So you'd rather stay on the welfare than get a job?
Well, you know, let me tell you something right now. I'm looking out there.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
All right, where was the last place you looked?
The other day.
Where?
Oh, let me see.
The other day's not the answer to where, you ass.
She's pounding the pavement. She does it every day. Just walking is pounding the pavement.
What day was that? Dunkin' Donuts? Where?
No. Crossing Guard.
Crossing Guard?
Yes. I tried for that.
You tried for
that? I put an application in for that. You know, these people, they have to call me back in order for me to go back there again.
Would you call you back if you wandered into a school with that awful stringy hair and alcohol in your breath? I want to cross children. Idiot.
It is not like that at all.
You look like Throw Mama from the Train.
Oh.
You really do.
You're saying that to me.
It's the truth, though. We haven't seen you in 2 years. I don't know what the hell happened to you in our time off.
Let my hair grow, that's all.
Well, how about you wash it?
I wash it every day.
You don't.
Yes, I do.
You wash it with oil. Probably Wesson
oil.
No,
I don't.
All right, so what's going on with the crossing guard thing? They just haven't called you back?
I put in an application, and I guess they're going to call me back whenever an opening comes up.
They can't hire you as a crossing guard. Because the cars would never go. They'd stop thinking there was a truck in the street.
Never. No.
I thought Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall.
That's the last job I put in for.
Who's in the background?
A friend of mine that's, you know, he's just having a cigarette and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Why are they up at this hour?
Well, because, well, there's only one person here. And the phone woke him up.
Ugh.
So
yeah.
He's just having a cigarette.
And what was he doing there?
Huh?
And what was he doing there? Hanging out last night?
He's in the other room.
Are you having sex with this person?
No.
Another party at Lady Di's last night, perhaps?
No.
A little late night drinking, hanging
out? Another drunk from the local bar?
No.
What's the name of your little club there? Lady Di's Welfare Flophouse?
No.
Ugh. Welfare mothers make better lovers.
No, that is not true at all.
Ugh. All right, so you're not having sex with this guy. You just drink a lot with him.
It's just a roommate that stays in another room.
She's lying. She's dying for this guy to bang him.
You are a compulsive liar,
yeah.
Lady
no,
Di.
Not.
Yes, you are. Everyone knows it, and everyone says it, even Marion.
No.
You're a compulsive liar. You're incapable of telling the truth.
Yeah, do you want to have sex with this guy?
No.
Why not?
because he's just a friend.
He says he's just a fan. Oh, baby.
And he'd probably rather fuck Biz Markie than her.
No difference.
All right, we're getting out of this. This is boring. Lady Di, we'll check in with you, all right?
Check in with me. You go ahead and do that.
Go get some help, please. We say it every time we talk to you. Stop drinking.
Yeah, you got to get off the sauce.
There's drinking and then there's drinking. We saw you. The alcohol is taking effect. Your face is bloated. Your liver is not working that well these days. I could just see it by looking at you.
All I got to do is exercise, and I'll be okay. And, you know, the drinking, I did cut back on that.
You got to stop.
Okay.
Stop with the cut back. Just cut the drinking out. Go to a meeting.
All right. Thank you. Starker Patty, any final thoughts?
I wonder how she appeared when she went to that interview. Did she get dressed? Did she look nice? They're not going to give you
I have nice clothes for that.
You don't have
to. You know, you got to dress for success. You got to dress in business.
God. Okay. Patty's telling us she's got to dress for success.
You know, even a dishwasher gets dressed up for his interview.
I hate to admit this, but I love the new Patty.
Patty is
hilarious.
Motivated. She's a go-getter.
If you guys only knew, Patty was a mess, too, when we first met her. But look at Patty making something of her life.
Patty, are you on any kind of medication?
No, I'm not. Just albuterol for asthma.
She's like like one of those little yappy dogs. She needs medication for her asthma.
Patty's like Adrian.
She's just a mess.
Yeah, but she's getting her act together. She doesn't sell turtles anymore.
I could see Lady Di showing up for a job interview in did you have one of your big T-shirts on and that tinfoil bling you wear around your neck?
No, I don't go like that for job interviews.
Were you wearing a smart pants suit?
Maybe a smart pants suit, but no. Yeah.
Well, what did you have on?
Huh?
What did you have on?
Well, I have nice pants on, and I have a nice shirt.
A nice shirt. Did it have buttons on it? Or did it pull over?
Buttons. Buttons on the shirt.
Yeah.
If it has Mickey Mouse in the front, it's not a nice shirt.
It's not a nice shirt.
No, it doesn't have Mickey Mouse in the front.
All right. Why are we continuing?
I don't know. I'm fascinated.
All right. Starker Pat, anything else?
No, not at all.
You ought to invest with somebody smart. You ought to go to a brokerage firm and invest your money.
Oh, man.
Lady Di, you don't even know what that means. The fake laugh again. All right. Thank you, Lady Di.
Early in the morning. Okay.
Wait, Lady Di, Lady Di.
What? Okay.
Stalker Patty?
Yes.
All right.
Have a good day.
All right, you too. Bye-bye. She goes. Can't help it. I love the new Stalker Patty.
Lady Di, you know, you ought to eat from the four food groups. She's just a bevy of knowledge, of helpful knowledge these days.
She takes control, though. It's hilarious.
She was a mess that slept under the stairs in our studio.
Now she's like a go-getter.
And now she's the one telling everybody how to better their lives.
Hey, Doug, what's going on?
Yeah, going back to Norton's little cereal bowl there.
Yeah.
He'll stick his tongue up a whore's asshole, but he won't eat out of a cereal bowl.
Isn't that classic?
We used to talk about this, and I've given up on that, too. I don't get it.
You're right. I can't even argue. I know it's not
He will
consistent.
Take a log in the face, but...
Who won't?
A bowl that looks relatively clean that you could even wash out more, you won't use. I don't get it.
No. Oh, now what do we
got? Oh, my God. Thank you.
Dude, you're up to 1, 2, 3, 4 bowls.
There are four bowl type
things. No, there's not. There's two bowls. There's this odd little Ziploc thing, which will serve as a bowl... And there's this thing, which is...
It's a sandwich
It's not
container.
A bowl.
But you can use mine.
No, I can't.
Why?
I clean it
out?
Absolutely not.
No.
Eating out of another man's bowl?
That's gay. That is totally gay.
Ugh. You eat ass.
So what? I'm not saying it's right.
Not yours.
Exactly. At least I don't want to stand there and smell it while I'm urinating, swamp ass.
All right, Jesus. All right, Doug, you bring up a good point. We don't get what that's about either, so... All right, we have to go to Marion.
Oh, brought me this.
Oh, wow. No.
The other half of the retarded Laverne and Shirley. Yes, Marion.
Hi, Opie. Hi, Anthony. How's everybody doing?
Great, Marion.
I just want to let you know that Diane
What is this, retard hour?
Diane...
Get Corky on the phone for our celebrity interview.
Diane has been looking for a job. I've sent her to some places, too.
Oh, really?
And you know what? I tell her that you give places like 4 or 5 days. If they don't call you back, then you call them. But you see, she's not driving right now because her vehicle's kaput, you know?
Oh, so her car is broken down?
Yeah, her car is broke, and she's just, like, walking to place with some bus in it. So, you know, it's tough. Believe me.
She's on
trying.
A slippery slope. Broken down car, no job. Before you know it, she's going to be homeless.
She's running a flop house.
She is on public assistance because I told her to go to public assistance for help.
Doesn't she have a kid?
Before she was going to end up being homeless, I told her to go for help. Believe me, when I was in my 20s, I had the same problem that she has.
Yeah, how old is she?
But she's not in her 20s.
She's 42. I know that. But when you work in a place so long and they get rid of you, it's very hard to find something close to what you were making.
All right.
You know.
Why'd they get rid of her?
I don't know the whole story.
What do you think? Tell us.
It has something to do with her drinking.
It's none of my business.
It had something to do with her drinking, right?
It's none of my business.
Oh, that means yes.
No, it's not. It's none of my business.
I'm smart.
There is a friend of hers that's also a friend of mine who works there, and they didn't just get rid of Diane. They got rid of about 25, 30 people.
All right. Who's the guy that's...
Same time.
Who's the guy at Lady Di's house?
I don't know. I don't know him because I never met him, but I know her other friend.
Yeah.
And he seems okay. I mean, these people this guy that stays there, he's pretty cool. I mean, I've called her up and we've got on the phone and talked.
Is he paying her rent or something?
He's helping her out.
Helping her out.
In other words, he's like, yeah, you know, he takes her places. Since her car is not drivable right now, he does take her places where she can go put
drops
applications.
Drops her off to clients?
No, come on. No, I mean, she's, you know, guys.
Less than zero.
I'm listening to it.
Guy gives good head and is dead.
Guys, I'm listening to it, and come on, she really is trying. I mean, she's in a jam right now, yeah, but, you know, she's having a hard time. And
Marion, we talked to her last week.
Trying to walk through a door.
We talked to her last week. It was like a Wednesday morning, and she was S-faced.
I don't know, because I was already at work, but the reason why I'm still home is because I don't have to work today. I have to go to jury duty. But I'm,
oh
yeah, so go
imagine
ahead,
looking over at the jury where your life is hinged and looking over and Marion is sitting there.
Yeah. And you look at this cross-eyed freak.
Hey.
DNA evidence, you got a fat muppet
deciding
your life.
Jim. Hey, Jim,
my DNA, how do you spell that? Idiot.
I'm going to see you on Saturday. I'm going to that show and I hope you bomb.
All right, thank you. You know, why are we doing this to ourselves?
Know. All right, Marion, thank you.
Marion, you can't hope I bomb. That's very bad luck.
No. I hope you bomb on Saturday. I'm only kidding, Jimmy. I love you.
All right, but who are you coming with?
My husband.
What are you guys doing? Anything else? Or are you just coming to the stupid show?
Just me and my husband are going because Diane can't go. There's a reason why she can't go. She doesn't have train fare, and I'm not going to give her the train fare to go. Because then she'll want me to buy her a drink, and I'm not going to do that. You know, I'm trying to get her to stop, you know, cut back. Hello? They hung up.
Who is she yelling at?
They hung up.
All right, in honor of Retard Hour to start the program.
I find the evidence very compelling.
Right.
Oh, could you just see her sitting there in that jury box?
Imagine, I think she might be the juror that's messing up the Scott Peterson trial.
Scott Peterson?
They're having a problem with one of the jurors. I wonder if it's her.
Your Honor, can I look at the boat again? I don't think it could hold the weight of the body in the cinder block. So let me put my head. My head is just like a cinder block. I'll put it in the boat and we'll see if it floats. Your Honor, that's very. I think we can't reach a decision. This should be a mistrial.
The old jury booth probably looks like a whack-a-mole game. Old wacky characters in there, just an awful head sitting in that jury booth. Oof. Well, that's what they. Those are the type of people they get on the jury, man. Everyone else is smart enough to figure out how to get out of it.
We're going to be sequestered? What does that mean?
All right.